That's good. I'm just concerned now because I've got to, when I screw them back into the back of the chamber, I'm twisting the wires and these haven't had time to set. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to put the camera. That's going to the chamber. That's the rocket fuel. That's paraffin wax and PVS pellets molded, and then we get into the combustion chamber. This is the ignition chamber, and there is my wires, and that looks all right to me. They're still in place, they've not pulled out, so I'm okay with that. No, all good.
So what are you actually doing here?
I'm just joining the igniters.
So all of this has been made on the Tormach, has it, Michael?
This is all lathe work and then milled flaps. It's all from the Tormach, and then these are off the Tormach lathe. Really, really nice piece of machinery.
Because you're not actually an engineer.
No. Yeah, I'm an electrician. Self-taught, learned it all off YouTube, and you can, and there's lots of help. And any issues, you know, Tormach crew are very good. Was it NC, New York, CNC? I watched him when he was in his little garage. There's a bit of Vaseline to help the O-ring pop into place. Take this in as well. So all being well, we should launch tomorrow.
Good.
Thinking.
I'm thinking I'll put number three on number two. But that's okay. I should be able to find that. There we go. Put a camera at number two. Let's see if that's behaving itself. One's all right. Oh yeah, I can see the other one. Yeah, they look good. So, last one is there.
I put the dog in.
I mean, I pressure tested the cylinders without pressure tape being put on the threads, and they were all sealed up to 150 psi, so that's all good. So the O-ring is working great, but I'm just putting additional thread tape on. It makes me feel a bit better, because once you get a leak with a rocket, it's over. I've had small leaks and it burns its way through under high pressure.
Even though this is steel?
Yeah. Oh yeah, totally. So many things that on the day, you only need one of them not working right.